The Obama administration still facing significant backlash since news broke about that $400 million cash payment to Iran for four U.S. hostages, or at least at the same time they were being released. Now, some that came in a statement released by New York Congressman Lee Zeldin, and it read in part, when deals like this are cut, one has to truly wonder whether the president has no idea what he's doing or if he knows exactly what he's doing and is playing for the other team or some other team. That last part kicked up just a little bit of controversy on its own. Well, the man himself, Congressman Lee Zeldin, is here to discuss with me now. So the implications is that President Obama may have knowingly helped the enemy, aided the enemy?
Well, either he doesn't know what he's doing or his priorities are misplaced. When you are, the negotiation process, the deal itself, the purchase of heavy water, this negotiated release of our four American hostages, all of these examples, he actually wants the American public to believe that providing $400 million cash at the same exact moment of releasing four American prisoners, hostages, that that's a coincidence. And we've seen this in other areas of his foreign policy. He'll put 50 troops into Syria in the middle of the hottest spot on the globe and then tell everyone that they're not there on a combat mission, even though it's divorced from reality. So what's happening is that the president is prioritizing domestic politics over national security. I don't know if this is a higher priority placed on loyalty to his party or higher priority on loyalty to his own legacy, but a lot of his decisions are not in the best interest of American foreign policy.
Well, you wouldn't go as far as to say he's deliberately committing treason?
No, I'm not suggesting that at all. I'm suggesting that his decisions have shown that he either doesn't know what he's doing. Take the example of when negotiating the deal, he was saying June 30th as a deadline was important. We have to have this deal by June 30th, but the Iranians didn't care if we woke up July 1st and there was no deal. The administration laid out all of these different red lines for the deal when negotiating, and then they crossed all of these different red lines they said they would never cross. So it's possible that he just doesn't know how to negotiate a good deal, but if he knows exactly what he's doing, it's obvious that he's prioritizing domestic politics or loyalty to party over loyalty to
national. There's no doubt he was out negotiated in part because it was pretty clear to everyone he wanted this deal done, and he would do anything to have it done. You know, just moments ago, the RNC took Hillary Clinton's press conference today, and they turned it around, and they have a new ad. I want to share it with the audience. We've got an exclusive on it.
Hillary Clinton put our national security at risk, and she's still lying.
Director Comey said that my answers were truthful.
That's not truth.
Even the Washington Post says Hillary Clinton lied, comparing her to Pinocchio.
I may have short-circuited it, and for that, I...
Careless, reckless, crooked, putting her interests ahead of national security. Don't let Hillary Clinton do it again.
Congressman, it sounds similar to what you were describing with Barack Obama in the sense that whatever their ultimate goal is, and I think a lot of people think with him is that he always wanted to be president of the world. You know, he's always wanted the affection of the whole world, and they had to shine and smile at him and to make him feel good. That was a pretty slick ad. They put it out quickly. They get it out there. Do you like what you just saw?
I think it's going to be an effective ad for those who are still trying to decide who they're going to vote for, and people who are, they're undecided, they're prioritizing national security. And when we talk about character, so much the rest of the media loves to attack Donald Trump on the character piece, and in their questions we'll give a free pass to Hillary Clinton, but the fact is on character, a lot of those undecided voters, they know Hillary Clinton, they don't trust her. And I think it's an effective message, and we'll see a lot more of this between now and November.
Right.
For those undecided voters who are prioritizing national security and looking for that strong character that Hillary Clinton lacks as well.
You know, of course, in that ad it mentions the Washington Post with the four Pinocchios for that Chris Wallace interview. Moments ago, AP came out and also shot a lot of holes in this semi-press conference she gave out today. How are you feeling overall in terms of the momentum? Obviously, it was a tough week. You think like maybe things are going to turn around, shift, and start to move in the other direction?
It's really up to the candidate a lot. It's a lot of what happens is completely out of Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton's control. And a lot of it's out of Donald Trump's control. But what he can control is that, we all have thoughts in our head. We're at Thanksgiving dinner, our uncle says something, we have a thought that maybe we want to share, we decide, Mom, I'm going to keep that thought to myself. It is important for Donald Trump to have the opportunity to be able to defend himself on policy when there's a substantive attack made by a Gold Star family. However, there is no need to question why the woman who's standing there, the mother, is silent. Right. Just keep that thought to yourself. It doesn't matter. Stay on topic. Defend yourself on policy and move on.
All right. Congressman, thank you very much.
Good to be with you.
Really appreciate it.